Getting back into circulation could be painful, I was told. But they also say fortune favors the brave, and I figured I wasn't too old. But take this tale I'm about to tell you as a warning for the wise. If you don't meet your women in charities or church, you might be in for a big surprise. I put on a shirt that seemed to be cool, got some neck chains and a watch, greased up my hair, and I bought new boots, tightened the belt in another notch. Thought about trying upscale, but I landed at Wanda's instead. He told me if you can't score there, man, you're either not trying or you're already dead. She was pretty in a pair of County Legion sort of way. I was working on jack number three. Introduced myself as Dave. She said she went by Amberlee. Something clicked, it all fell into place. The booze and the conversation flowed. Little did I know I'd talk my way into a Dateline episode. Now it looks like the family luck is holding up. I don't even know why I tried. I picked the one girl in the bar, probably wanted by the FBI. I could use a big plate of nachos and a flashlight as I walked alone. Out of gas, dead phone, perished stone. Said we might want to get a room. She said she had something else in mind. If I could follow her back to her place, she said we'd have a better time. So I found myself chasing the taillights of an old Dodge 4x4. We kept rising away into the hillside until I couldn't see the city anymore. Was a single wide from the 70s with a pit bull chained on guard. Amberlee's mama stood at the door, her children met us in the yard. Right there and then I should have turned around, but I had no time to decide. Amberlee and her kids, they all grabbed my arms, and the five of us went inside. We adjourned into a back room as the kids watched late-night TV. Mama said, you just pull that curtain across if you want to get some privacy. And Amberlee handed me a water bong, kicked off her shoes and started to change. Believe it or not, that's up to you, but that's when things really started to get strange. Turns out the family luck is holding up. We were always a clan that roamed. It figures I picked the only girl in the bar with no doors in a mobile home. But she sure did have some dynamite grass. Now I'm lost in the twilight zone. Out of gas, headphone, and very stone. We kept lighting up and gurgling. We shared a jug of some sort of wine. I amended my expectations, but I was still having an alright time. Everything was getting hazy. Everything seemed to bleed and breathe. Like magic, then two giants appeared, and neither one of them seemed very pleased. Turns out these two were Fred and Dwayne, her brother and old man, respectively. It just added to the confusion, because they look like twins to me. Fred, I guess it was, took the ball from my hand and said, do you know how much this stuff costs? I couldn't recall any English right then. He said, buddy, you're sounding like you're kind of lost. Then Dwayne produced a Bowie knife and started picking at his boots. He said, I might consider chipping in. He thought it might be the decent thing to do. He took the cash from my shaking hand and said, take off them disco chains. He smiled and handed the bong back to me and said, I guess now we can all be friends again. Well, concern turned to paranoia, and paranoia turned to fear. When I noticed a cutout paper wall about a fat white guy that had disappeared. As I hurdled the kids and ran to my car, I could hear her laughing with Fred and Dwayne. It was sort of like that old Eagles song, but without any pink champagne. I guess that family luck is holding up. I should have tried those dating sites. The figures I picked the only girl in the bar from where the heels have eyes. I live to see another day, although I'm stranded in the great unknown. Out of gas, dead phone, there is stone. Out of gas, dead phone, there is stone.